Too soft. Not smart enough. Won't fit in. Just not cut out for it. This is what I say to everyone who says it's too hard to increase the number of women in engineering. By the year 2030, Engineers Canada wants to see that at least 30% of newly licensed engineers in Canada are women. Right now, only 17% of newly licensed engineers are women, and only 12% of all practicing engineers are women. This low representation has been identified as a problem for the profession for decades, and yet the number's been slow to rise. Meanwhile, other professions like law and medicine have already achieved 50% participation. Like others, our profession faces tough challenges, an unwelcoming or hostile culture, unstated implicit biases, gendered processes, and often a false impression that women are inferior to men. These all make it difficult for women to thrive in engineering. Post-secondary institutions, regulators, employers, engineers, and our broader professional community are working hard at addressing those issues. But there's a great deal of room for deeper change. Women still leave engineering in high numbers, and countless others never consider joining. It's not because women aren't cut out for it or because we don't fit in. It's because there are still barriers women face. Together with allies from across the profession, we're breaking them down. As an engineer working in a cement plant, I faced all those barriers and more. I had to fit in as one of the guys, but I also had supporters and mentors who helped me succeed and embrace the profession that I love. Now, as I find myself in a leadership role, I'm proud of the work that's being done to create more success stories like mine. Engineers are creative thinkers. We're problem solvers. We're doers. As a profession, I know we're capable of creating the change we want to see. As we celebrate International Women in Engineering Day, we're committed to act. It's time to rise to the challenge. There is a place for everyone in engineering. Let's get to 30 by 30.